Welcome, everyone. How's everyone this morning? Good, good. I see a few new faces. I'm Cathy. And so nice to see a good turnout today. Welcome to September. It's here. Leaves are already starting to change color a little bit.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, yeah. I know. So make sure you have some weights. There's water if you didn't bring any, just over on the table. And make sure you have a little space with your neighbor. So stretch out, make sure you can move your arms. If not, just stagger your chairs a little bit. Welcome online, welcome here in our space. All right, let's sit a little taller. Maybe scoot forward on your chair a little bit. Just have your weights handy. And we're going to bring our arms down by our side. Bring your shoulders over top of the hips. Let's inhale, shrug the shoulders. Exhale, let them go. Inhale, shrugging. Exhale, releasing. Good. Warming up the body, these shoulder shrugs. Let's change these shrugs now. We're gonna do circles out of the shoulders. So roll up, down, and back, a little circular movement, up, down, and back. Good. Give your shoulders a little massage, warming things up. Maybe do one at a time. You can bend your elbow a little bit more, perhaps, if that feels good. And even turning to look in that direction as the arm and the elbow lift. Good. And let's return center. Rest your hands on the lap. And then turn to look right. Back center. Turn looking left. And back center. So just warming up our neck. Moving gently, that's it. And pause, center, let's bring our hands together, press each finger, thumb, knuckle together. Notice that you might feel a stretch through the hands and fingers and the forearms. Sit taller, lift your heart, lift your chest. Let's inhale, reach up. Exhale, draw it back into that start position. Inhale, reaching up. You might follow your hands if that feels okay for your head and neck posture. So feel your feet grounding, your sitting bones. One more time. And then bringing the hands back to the thighs. Let's inhale, fill up the belly, arch your spine as we gaze up. Exhale, draw the belly in as we flex the spine, look down. Inhale, extension of the spine. And exhale, flexion of the spine. And so know that flexion might not be good for your spine if your doctor has said not to flex your spine. Just stay really tall and neutral and focus on the breath. Good, one more time. And back center. Good. And you might widen your feet a little bit, about chair width. Let's bring our fingers facing inwards a bit and then stirring out of the hips, making another circular pattern. Moving gently here, making these as big or as little as you like. You might feel movement in the ribs, the belly, your hips. That's it. And let's circle the other direction. So we're circling the upper torso. Hands can rest on the legs. Good, one more time. And coming back center. Let's slide back in our chair, perhaps. As much as you can. You might feel the back of the chair, but still sit really tall, engaging those abdominal muscles, hands on the thighs, or gently hanging on to the chair. Let's press the legs away and then bending the knees. Pressing away, bending the knees. So warming up our quadricep muscles. That's it. Just allowing that movement. (Laughs) Good. And then hold the legs long, point your toes, and flex your feet. Point your toes, flex the feet. Notice where you feel that sensation. Where do you feel it the most? Good. And then circling our feet in one direction.
Where are you supposed to feel that the most? The knees, around the knees?
No, not necessarily. Everybody will be different. Yeah. Yep, it really just depends. You might feel it most in the calves or the shins, maybe the knees, maybe your quadriceps from holding the legs up. Give your legs a little shake. There's no right or wrong. And then just adjust your seat so you feel comfortable, secure still. Hug one knee, and now you might grab the shin or you might hook your arms underneath, either or. You could also use your band to help facilitate that stretch if you would like. So we're breathing into the belly, into the rib cage, and into this hip. Good. So remember, just to do what you can. If you're new to this class, welcome. Do what you can, make adjustments, and please listen to your body if something doesn't feel quite right. Now we can pick up this foot and this leg, so lower leg, or hanging on this way.
Rocking. Replaced.
Okay. That's okay.
I'm not gonna be able to do
that. That's okay. Or you can grab your back of your shoe. That might be easier. And then we're going to place this ankle above or below the knee. So any kind of external hip rotation. So the femur bone is turning outwards a little bit. Still sitting tall. Good. Breathing into this hip. Yep, so those external hip muscles, we have 6 external hip muscles here. Large one, the piriformis, you might have heard of that. And breathing into the hips. It's a really good stretch after walking for our class here today. Maybe you're doing housework and you've stopped for some stretching. Try to throw that in throughout your daily activities even. All right, let's bring that leg down. Notice how that side feels. Might feel a little bit of extra warmth, circulation, movement. So let's draw that other knee in, either grabbing the shin or behind the leg. Hug it in as comfortably close to your belly as you can, because it is a good stretch for digestion. So you might even do this stretch before you even get out of bed in the morning. Lying on your back, hugging that knee in. A little stretch for your spine, for the hip. Deep breaths. Good. And then picking up the lower leg, you can either grab your shoe, your shin, or the sneaker, or your footwear. Rocking back and forth. It's a little movement, if that's doable. Good. And then resting that ankle above or below the knee. Sitting tall, lift and lengthen the spine. If you're not feeling enough of a stretch, hinge forward, but with the spine really long. That's it. Just breathing. And releasing slowly that leg back to the floor. And notice how that side feels. Good. From here, let's come up to stand. So let's come up to stand in behind your chair. Nice and tall. Feet are going to be about hip bone width apart. Have a micro bend in the knees. So we're going to do calf raises. Rising up on your toes and release the heels. Rising up on the toes and release the heels. Take your time. Body tall. Lifting your heels. So we're strengthening our calf muscles. Working on posture. And of course, we're having fun. Just checking in, see if you're listening. No. Great work, everyone. Last two. And last one. Good. Pause for a minute. Sink back into all points of the feet. This time we're going to lift our toes. Lift your toes, rock back. You're going to find your hips pressed back a bit. I'm going to turn just to show a side view of this one. So rocking back. So pulling up on the toes, working the shins or the tibialis anterior, those muscles in the lower, front lower leg. And this can help our walking gait, keeping our legs strong for walking to help prevent tripping. Good. Last two. And last one. Let's stay for a stretch. Let's take one leg back. So give each leg its own track, pressing that back heel towards the ground, front knee over the ankle. Now for extra balance challenge, you might lift one arm up. You might choose to lift both arms off the chair. So you decide, only if that feels good for you. Feel all the core muscles engaging through the torso. You might pick a focal point to gaze at to help your balance. Good, release one hand, the other. Step it in, just walk it out on the spot for a minute. Good, let's try the other side. So again, giving each leg its own track, take a lengthy step back, pressing your back heel into the floor. Again, you can hang on with both hands or you might take one hand out of the equation. Maybe both hands, and arms can be wherever you like. That's it. Finding balance while we stretch that calf muscle. That's it, looking good. Let's bring one hand back to the chair, the other. Step it in and walk it out on the spot. I'm just gonna turn my chair back to face front. Good, and let's stay actually in behind our chair. So still behind the chair, and actually I'll angle a little bit so you can see at home. And we're gonna do bird dog. So we're gonna lift that opposite arm and leg, and then the other side. Good, opposite arm and leg. So taking your time, nice and tall, your gaze still at the horizon. We're strengthening our spine here, strengthening the back of the hip. We're working on mobility through the shoulder. There's a lot going on here. That's it. Looking good, looking good. Couple more times. Last one each way. Good, let's pause, hang on to the chair, walk back, coming into a stretch for your back. Bend the knees, lengthening your spine. And your gaze is a little bit forward to keep your head centered on your spine. Continue to breathe fully, breathe deeply. Good, take your time, start to walk towards the chair, start to lift your torso. When you get to the top, pause, sink back into the feet and open the palms, shine your heart forward, reach out energetically through the hands, fingers, and lift your chest, lift your heart. Good. From here, inhale, reach up. Let's interlace the hands, exhale, make a little steeple with your pointer fingers. Grounding through our feet, let's take an in-breath together. Exhale, side bend. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, side bend. So again, just a comfortable range for your body. That's it. And you can always do this one hanging onto your chair. So maybe you hang onto the chair with one hand and do your side bend. So just know that your chair is always there for assistance. Let's try one more time. Good, and release. Good, let's come back to our chair. We're gonna grab our weights en route. So whatever you have at home for your weights, if you don't have weights, it might be two cans of soup, it might be two water bottles, two little balls, whatever you have. Just again, something to add a little bit of weight. So sitting tall, shoulders over hips. Let's start with that biceps curl and release. And a biceps curl and release. That's it. Looking good. Feet rooted, body tall. Let's try that two more times. Good. From here, bend your elbows 90 degrees and we'll raise our elbows out to the side. So a little shoulder side raise. Looking good. Exhaling as you press away, inhale, release. Maybe two more, you decide. Good, last one. Good, let's release the arms, roll the shoulders up, down and back a couple of times. Good, and then from here, take your dumbbells to the shoulders as our starting point. Keep your wrist flat or neutral. We're gonna press overhead and then bring it back to the shoulders. Pressing overhead and back to the shoulders. Looking good. So working the front of the shoulder joint here. You can also do one at a time if you're getting a little tired. We'll do just a few more. Good. Maybe two more. Good. On this last one, hold the arms up. Bring the weights together. Tighten your core. Be mindful of the back of the neck, bending the elbows, dumbbells behind the head, and then overhead. Behind. And press for our triceps. That's it. Looking good. So the back of the upper arm we're targeting here, the tricep muscle. Two more. Keep smiling. Last one. Good. Take it on down. Whew, those were tough. Roll it up, down, and back. Good work, everyone. Let's set one dumbbell aside, but grab some weight that feels comfortably challenging for your wood choppers. So now, if you're using lighter weights, you could hold two here. Widen your feet about chair width. And we're going to reach up on a diagonal and then pull down, lifting the opposite knee. Reach up on a diagonal and pull down. Two. That's it. Three. Pulling in the belly. Four. You've got it. So really good for our core muscles. One more time. And return center. Pause. Ground your feet nice and tall. Let's reach up on the opposite diagonal and then pull down, breathing out as we draw the knee up. Looking good. That's it. Lots of breath. Two more. And last one. Whew, really good. From here, let's grab both weights once again. Nice and tall in your chair. Let's bring the dumbbells to the side. Shoulders over hips. Let's do two together this time. So a bicep curl right into an overhead press. Doesn't get any fancier than that. All right, bicep curl, overhead press. Looking good. Working on our upper body strength, working on our posture. Remember, you can rest at any time or pause if you need to. That's it. A couple more times. Good, one more time. Good. Whew. Toes are tough. Draw your heels back to hold the dumbbells at your side, and we're going to do a sit to stand. So again, and an option with these is doing a partial squat. So I'll show both. So we're going to hinge forward, press through the feet, rise, squeeze your glutes, and then hinge back, have a seat. So sit to stand would be one option. Keep going, now have a seat. And then second option is just to start in this position, go down and up. So if getting out of the chair is just too much today, you can do these partial squats like this, or you can do the sit to stand. So either or. Let's do a few more of either of those options. That's it. Another option with the sit to stand is to prop your height of your hips by putting a couple cushions underneath your seat, but make sure they're sturdy, or a rolled blanket, a couple solid sort of rolled blankets, or something that's a little bit sturdy. Last two. And last one, let's stay standing. Flip the palms facing your thighs, nice and tall. And then from here, upright row. Good.
Hopefully these are good for their granny wings. Granny arms.
Eight. It sure is. Last one. Good work. Let's rest our dumbbells aside. We'll stay standing and come to the right side of your chair. So we can hang on to the chair and have one hand on the hip. We're going to work that outer leg. Yep. Yep. You can go like this as well. Works just as well. So either or. And we're going to raise that outer leg out to the side and back to the floor. Out to the side, back to the floor. Now, if you want to hang on with both hands, just keep going, but standing behind your chair. That's it. Body tall. Let's try two more on this side. Good, last one. Looking good. Pause, sink into both feet, relax that outside arm. Let's do a stretch. Reach it up and over.
Overlooks small town.
And reach it back and down. Good. Let's pick up one dumbbell. So options here, we can hang on to the chair, the hip, or your hand can be in your back pocket. And that outer hand's going to press out to the side with your dumbbell about shoulder height. Looking good. Micro bend in the knees to protect the knees. Last two. Good, last one. Good. And then from here, make sure you have room to step behind you. And we're going to do outside knee and foot leg again. Comes up, knee up, step back and down, knee up, and back and down. So aiming to keep our hips parallel, our shoulders, gazing at the horizon, looking good. Two more. On this last one, let's hold the knee up. Again, we might lighten how much we're hanging onto the chair, maybe a fingertip touch. So challenging your balance. Pick a focal point to gaze at. That's it. Whew. Good work. No, the chair's right there if you need it. Keep breathing. And release it down. Let's rest our dumbbell on the chair. Come to the other side of your chair. Again, hanging on to the chair, hand can be on the outer hip. Shift your balance to that outside leg, and then, inside leg. And then your outside leg presses away and touches the floor. Press away, and then put some weight down for a second on that foot. That's it. So working the muscles through the hip joint here. Good, one more time. Good, pause, sink into both feet, relax that outside arm. Let's reach it up for crescent moon stretch and a side bend, or a crescent moon. Reach it back up, float the arm down to your side. Good, we can pick up one dumbbell again. And maybe hanging on to the chair or the hip. Let's take that dumbbell out to the side and back center. Out to the side and return. That's it. Exhale as you press away. Looking good. Good, one more time, that's it. And then pause, bring that inside hand back to the chair. So the knee up, lunge back, here we go. Outside knee up, step back and down, knee up, and back and down. Take your time, use your breath. This last one, let's hold the knee up, lift your torso, lift your spine, maybe lighten how much you're hanging on for extra challenge. So we're working on balance. Looking good, that's it. Keep breathing, keep balancing. And release that foot down, release your weight aside. Maybe take opportunity for some water. And I'm gonna change our music. We're gonna pick up the pace here, pick up the beat. All right, time to dance it out or shake it out. You might march on the spot or you might sit in your chair and just march in a seated position. So lots of options here. That's it. So know that you can use your chair or maybe you're sitting and marching or tapping your feet and clapping your hands. That's it. So important to move our bodies so that if you're sitting throughout the day and you're feeling a little sluggish, maybe you get up and you put on your favorite record or you turn up the radio, listen to some music and move about your space a little. Maybe you phone a friend. Have a little dance party. That's it. You're never too old for that. Looking good, looking good.
Don't realize how stiff you get.
Yes.
Yeah.
Looking good. Woo! All right. Woo! Looking great. Come back behind your chair. Hang on to your chair. Feet hip bone width apart. And calf raises. Let's strengthen those calves once again. Rising up on the toes. You've got it. Nice and tall. Good, last one. And then pause, sink into your feet. Let's do those shin raises. Lift our toes, rock back, plant your feet. Lift your toes, rock back, plant your feet. Looking good. Good work, everyone. Last one. Good. And then I'm just going to turn my chair to the side a bit. You can stay as you are. So hip extension. So lightly hanging onto the chair, pressing that leg long, pressing, feeling that work in the back part of the hip glute area. That's it. Body tall. That's it. Almost there. Good. Last one each way. Good. And then coming to the right side of your chair, we can hang on to the chair, hang on to the hip. We're going to work that outside hip a little bit more. We're going to lift that outside knee up, circle around, back to the floor. So up in a little circular pattern or half circle, I guess. You've got it. Strong in your standing leg. Looking good. One more. And then bring that outside knee up. One leg balance stand once again. Maybe a fingertip touch to the chair. Working on balance. Good. Keep breathing. Keep noticing. Know that the chair is right there and the floor is just a toe tap away. Good. We're strengthening that hip flexor too on that outer hip. And let's take it down. Dance it out. Let's dance it out over to the other side of our chair. All right, here we go. Hand on the hip, hand on the chair. Outside knee up, circle around, back to the floor. Up, circle around, and release. That's it. Good. Keep gazing up for head and neck posture. That's it. One more time. Good. And then taking that outside knee up, maybe you stretch your arms out, keeping that inside hand maybe near the chair or lightly touching. Keep working on balance. Balancing from the ground up. Good. Notice your breath. Just breathing comfortably. And release that foot. Shake it out. Again, we can return to that dance for a moment. Maybe a hydrate en route. Really important to stay hydrated. Helps to allow your body to function more optimally. Good for our immune system, keeping our body strong. All right, let's see what song's coming next. Let's see if the beat's picking it up. Oh, this is okay. Looking good. That's it. Looking good. Looking good. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. So any kind of movement pattern, you might try some knees up. Looking good. You might hang on to the chair, maybe you add some arms. Good, maybe take the arms up. Let's keep the arms up, change the legs, kicking back, and then maybe you add the arms in, pulling down. Or maybe you swing them across. All right. Here's our favorite. Are we ready? Sing along. Looking good. Looking good, looking good. The YMCA. 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 Hey. Y-M-C-A. 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 Hey. Y-M-C-A. Y-M-C-A. Ooh, looking great, looking great. Let's come back to our chair. Picking up your dumbbells. Woo! All right, well, let's have a seat. We're gonna sit to stand again with our dumbbells. Feel free to do those partial squats instead, or grab a cushion and prop yourself up a little higher in your chair. So here we go. We're going to hinge, do a biceps curl, overhead press, take it down, hinge and have a seat. Or you could opt to do arms only. That's it. So feel free to modify. That's it. You've got it looking good. Good. Last two. Last one. Good. Let's stay seated. Biceps curl and down. Biceps curl and down. Now, for added challenge, you might lift your right foot to hover. Drawing in the belly. And then plant that foot, change feet, lifting the other foot to hover. Keeping the torso tall, abdominals drawing in. Last two, last one, and release. Set one dumbbell aside. Woo. Hold that dumbbell at your chest, widen your feet a little. We're gonna exhale, rock back, squeeze the glutes. Inhale to sit tall. Exhale, rocking back, inhale tall. So I'll show a side view. Rocking back, pulling the abdominals in. Squeeze the glutes. We're creating more space in front of the hip joint here. That's it. Good, last two. Good, last one. Good, from here, let's grab both dumbbells once again. And then bring those dumbbells to the thighs, draw your heels back, and then dumbbells out in front, a row. So wide grip row. Looking good. Belly drawing in gently. Last two. Good work, last one. Good, walk it back to the thighs, walk it back to the shoulders, turn the palms out this time, widen your feet for stability, let's press it overhead, shoulder press. Know that if this option doesn't work, you can rotate your palms facing inwards for your shoulder press, or you could do one hand at a time to slow the tempo down a little. Good job. Last two, I'm gonna do one at a time here. Last one each way, or two more. Good, let's take it down and down. Roll up, down and back. Whew. Good work. Good, from here, just one dumbbell once again. Or double up the weight for wood choppers. We'll do another set, reaching up on a diagonal. Pull it down, draw the belly in. You've got it. Two more. Last one. Good. Back center. Pause. Nice and tall. Let's change diagonal. Reach it up. Pull it down. You've got it. Lots of breath. Good work, everyone. Last two and last one. Whew, good work. Let's come up to stand and grab both dumbbells. You might double up your weight. And we're gonna use our chair as a bench. So pick a side, we'll do both. Stagger your stance and dumbbell shoulders square to the floor. We're gonna do a row. So dumbbell row, you decide on the weight. You can do it seated as well if you like. Good, let's change sides. So change sides, stagger your feet. If you're seated, you can stagger your feet a bit and just do a pull up like this. Good, that's it. Looking good, keep a micro bend in that support elbow if you're standing. Oh yes, yep, always, just so you don't lock out the knee joint. Yep. Abdominals gently drawing in. Last two, and last one, good. Now take a weight in each hand, stand nice and tall, and you can stand anywhere, or you might even stand just a little bit in front of your chair in case you need to have a seat partway through, so hinge back, but don't have a seat. Pull the dumbbells up. This is our start point, we're gonna press away. Bring it in. Press away. You can do it seated as well. And if you're seated, it might look like this. That's it. That's it. Last two. And last one. Good. Nice and tall. Let's roll the shoulders up, down, and back a few times. Good. That's it. And then turn your palms facing forward. Let's come up halfway, all the way down. Halfway bicep curl, all the way down. One more time, then stay halfway. Reset your posture, all the way up, halfway down. All the way up, put the brakes on, yeah. So just halfway, nice and tall. One more time, this time all the way down, all the way up, full range of motion. You've got it. Looking good. And last one, good. All right, you can set your dumbbells aside, or maybe you keep your dumbbells for dancing and moving or marching. So you decide, dumbbells or no dumbbells, or maybe you pick up your lighter set. And we'll just move and dance a little, move our feet about. Know that you can hang on to the chair at any time. All right, grooving with the tunes. Looking good, looking good. Looking good, looking good. How's everybody doing? Still thumbs up? Looking good, looking good. Great work, everyone. Great work. Let's come to the right side of our chair or just pick a side because we're going to do both again. Inside hand hangs onto the chair. Outside arm reaches up. And then we're going to lift that outside knee and get a little side crunch here. Working those oblique muscles. A little side flexion through the torso. Two more, last one, good. Let's go over to the other side and good athletic stance. Reach your outside arm up and then lift that outside knee. A little side crunch here. That's it. You got it. Two more, and last one. Good, make your way back to your chair. You can set your dumbbells aside. And from here, we're going to turn to face your right. Scoot forward on the chair a little bit, hang on to the chair as you do that, freeing up that front hip. Square off your shoulders, nice and tall. We're gonna stretch this hip flexor. So we're gonna reach the outside arm up. Reach up and out of that hip, maybe a little bit of a side bend. Hang on to the chair with your back hand. Front hand reaches up, that's it. Keep breathing. Keep pressing through the feet, feeling the action of the leg muscles here. Reach it back up, float the arm down, help that leg forward. Good, let's turn, face center, keep turning. I'm gonna repeat that stretch on the other side, so scoot forward a little bit on your chair to free up that front hip. Square off your shoulders and hips, adding the front arm, reach it up, side bend, or just staying very tall and linear. Just breathing here. Just noticing. Reach it back up. Float that arm down. Help it forward. Turn to face center. I'm just going to change up my music once again. All right. Changing gears, slowing it down a little bit. Hug that right knee in. And cross it over for that external hip stretch above or below the knee. Good, just breathing into the hips. And maybe we had a turn towards your right, hang on to the chair, outer hand on the knee. A little easy twist perhaps. And back center, release that leg. Good. Let's hug the other knee in, either grabbing the shin or underneath. And coming into that external hip stretch on this side, ankle above or below the knee, sitting tall, lift the heart. Breathing into the hips. Maybe we add that turn or gentle twist towards your left or whatever knee's on top here. And back center, uncrossing. Good. From here, nice and tall, let's bring our right arm up. Bend the elbow, pat yourself on the back for working so hard. Other arm to help facilitate your stretch. Lift your chin, center your head posture. Breathing into the shoulders, the tricep. Deep breaths. That's it. Releasing the arms, roll the shoulders. Good. Let's reach our other arm up, reach through the shoulder blades. And here, nice and tall. Notice how this side feels in comparison. Breathing into any tightness you might be feeling. And releasing down, roll the shoulders. Good. And resting. So from here, let's take our ear to the right shoulder. We might let our left arm dangle. Adjusting the angle, tilting the chin a little. An option to place that left hand towards your back pocket, maybe resting a little bit on the chair. Just let the head fall heavy to deepen the stretch. Then roll the chin center, bring both hands forward. And bring your gaze back to the horizon. Good, let's do the other side. So gently let your ear start to fall to the left. Option to let this right arm hang. Feeling that stretch through the neck, maybe tilting the chin slightly to change the angle. You might even place that hand towards your back pocket. Maybe it's resting on the chair a bit. Keep breathing. Adjusting the angle. Head falling heavy. Rolling the chin center, bring both hands forward, turn the palms up, draw your elbows back towards your waistline a little, softening the hands and fingers, shoulder blades relaxing down and back. And bringing our gaze to the horizon, nice and tall. And we can just gently turn left and right a couple times. Work at your own pace. And returning center. Good. And then reach your arms forward. Wrap them around. Grab those shoulder blades. Give yourself a big hug for working so hard. Thanks for coming today. That wraps up our session for today. Thank you.